How do you, when you're talking with customers, advise them or work with them on their AI journey?
One, you have to have a long-term plan and a big picture. Without that, you will just be random in terms of the things that you deal with. And instill a data culture and go away from, we always did it this way, we were always successful, I have a gut feeling too. Let me look at data. And that is very, very key for the new digital enterprise and particularly how you want to leverage artificial intelligence as a new capability.
Our team, before we went through this digital transformation in the logistics space, were operational. It was more chasing freight. So we would be on a phone call on a Friday night at 11 o'clock, trying to find out where that shipment is for that VIP customer. Now, what we've done is our people are much more digitally aware. So we've become data analysts. And that's changed the makeup of the organization and how we think and utilize the data. It's now also interesting in, we do every week, we'll sit down as an entire group and we'll review the metrics and we'll review this combination of data to look at how did we do the past week, how are we doing currently, and are we on track for our deliverables this coming week. We went from subjective and emotion in the way that we talk to each other. Now we just talk to each other through the form of data.
Talk a little bit about the cultural transformation that is necessary for Tetra Pak. You're designing a very advanced automation. How do you bring your workforce along, your managers, your factory floor workers?
You know, if you take the people who work closest to customers, the engineers that have to go and fix problems and these things, they follow very quickly. Because we also make them a bit more intelligent, because with mobile devices and so, we give them information. So, they of course become more intelligent in the eyes of the customer. So most of them really like it. We try to train our staff as much as possible. We try to demystify the hype around digital. You know, so when people talk about artificial intelligence, 99% of our staff would not know what is that. Yeah, I can read about AI, but what is it practically? So we organize sessions where they're allowed to do it themselves a little bit. And then they can say, well, now I've done it. And then, it becomes much more natural for them to talk about. And then we also organize these type of sessions where they can come up with ideas. What would be a good application? What would be a good use case for customers? So that's what we do with our current staff.
We're respecting that people are scared sometimes, that they're afraid. And we would just keep on talking and opening up the door, being fully transparent until people fully understand what they're doing, and we're respecting their concerns. And we're doing a lot of small changes and a lot of small steps. We don't make big jumps. We like challenges. And we need to manage them. So change management and challenge management is basically the same.
When we've talked to companies for this book, we've heard a lot about the digital transformation, but we've also heard a lot about the cultural transformation that's necessary. How is that going at MTorres? How are you bringing along your plant floor workforce?
The workers will have to adapt to this new scenario with these new tools. The challenge for me is the organizational fact. With this trend, we are moving from an organization of executing tasks towards an organization where teams collaborate and look for new opportunities of efficient process, etc. 50% of the company are engineers, so they will adapt because it's their work to look for new technologies and try to integrate them. We also have some assembly workforce, but they are very used to integrate design to assembly, integrate design and assembly in the same process. But of course, we will have to transform ourselves.
It used to be we would somehow have very interesting conversations about the definition of on time. Okay. Now that we take that data and we can show it to them in output visual form, it takes away the sting when you have to relay that something is not happening as you projected it to be. What's also interesting is the entire supply chain community has oriented themselves into data. And so we're all trying to quickly figure out how can we leverage data for the greater good.